whale replied with a snort as he crossed his arms. If it's you, I think of all the worst possibilities. Ouch, I'm hurt. Do you really think of me that way? I wonder. I didn't really think the switch was as worth the battle. Clutching the broom handle in my hands, I tried to reason with them. You guys, please don't fight. With a tilt of the head, Dion glanced at me. The surprise in his expression caught me off guard. His falling smile was sweet and teasing. Don't worry. This is normal for us. Shaking his head to the top of Dion, towards the direction he'd come from. Anyway, just come if you want to play with someone love. No, thank you! I know you're a flirt, but we have Royal's route to handle first. Sorry! Even though he insisted to Royal that his meaning was innocent, I couldn't help agreeing with the grumpy bear's interpretation. I forced a smile anyway. Sure. Do you take good care of our guest, Royal? With a wave, Dion went on his way. Royal watched in a huffy silence until Dion rounded the corner and disappeared, then exhaled a petulant sigh. How bothersome. I know, right, dude? Come now. Miss Maria won't be happy if she sees us slacking off in here. There's a note in his voice that I suggested I obey. I'm thinking back to my first meeting with Miss Maria. I didn't dare argue with him. We ended up at the library, and boy was it huge. Well, it seemed huge compared to the small room of books I was used to back at the village. I stood at the doorway in awe, wondering just how many books was I housed there. Must have stayed there for some time because Royal gave a deliberate cough before advancing towards the shelves. When I turned to look at him, he glared back at me. Then again, I was already getting used to his glares. It seemed to be the trademark of his, so my day wouldn't have been complete without one of them. Wait, talking about trademarks, give me just one second, guys. So as long as we're talking about freaking that, speaking of trademarks, do you mean like actually, let's go to some bar.
Okay, I want, when I get home with Papa, you're going to be in some different clothes.
Yeah.
You're going to wash some of that stuff on your eyes and the lips.
When I got home that night, I notified my dad that I had all my things.
Okay, and I want, when I get home, all the clothes have to be picked up. And the shoes in a box.
Yeah,
like,
talk in, like,
soften him up a little bit. Hopefully.
True.
So, are they talking about like something like this?
Was any of my laundry
done?
Yeah.
What? Hold on, guys. So, are they talking about, like... Hold on, guys.
さっさと伏せろ。異性だけはいいな、スバル。 母親一人守れないというのに。
黙れ!
So, like...
お前たちの力など。
You mean that rival trademark? So it's that kind of trick. Like that trademark? Blah blah blah, it seemed to be the trademark of his, yeah? Thank you. that media refusal comes to fruition. I guess he did not expect to continue being stubborn. What? It was obvious that you were having a hard time back there. Call my name. It was gentle, not threatening, and I forgot my previous determination and ignore where I was. Opening my eyes, I looked around with blurry vision, but there was nothing except the castle. Aura! Is it Goldilocks? What? The voice continued beckoning me as I looked back and forth across the whiteness of slow fingers and cut its way into the nothingness. I drifted towards it, only then realizing that neither of us were actually taking steps as the distant tunnels vanished. Is this a dream? Who is? This is frickin' Goldilocks, huh? My god, look at her! She's so... cute. Let's take a few minutes to admire her beauty, yeah?
Thank you.
eyes were vibrant blue, and her hair a cascade of long golden locks. Still coming closer, she extended her hand towards me. And I want to take her hand, unable to explain the calm I felt. I reached towards her. I saw smiling lips, as small as her hand. What do you think you're doing? My eyes flashed open at the cleft in the front of the arbor. And since fell, voice breaking through my ruby. Since I had been asleep, it was my sleep just to have my present. Okay, so this is Goldilocks freaking as a doll. Okay, just like last time, let's admire her for a little bit. Yeah, I will. Gold. My breath caught in my throat. Not only was I holding the doll's small hand, it felt impossibly warm. What? Blue eyes shone within the moonlight. Her faint pink lips were turned into a sweet smile. But the longer I looked at her, the more I saw a whisper of sadness behind that happy facade. There was something. Yeah, she's frickin' Goldilocks.
I didn't tell him anything.
I didn't get to dwell on it for long, however, before Royal's voice came after me again. You! What are you doing here? Icy chill is his raised voice, finally dragged me away from my thoughts. I blinked, looking a bit at how I was kneeling before a beautiful doll, my fingers gently holding onto her hand. Wait, what? Failing to produce an answer, I looked over at Roya with a half-panicked, half-angry expression. The thing was, I didn't know what I was doing here either. It must have been a dream, so I had sleepwalked to her. That sounded too silly to admit to Royal. He remained quite unimpressed. It had been a while since his glare that was that frozen. It's the middle of the night. What are you doing in her room? You know, just stuff and... or stuff, you know? Nothing really bad. Forehead furled with suspicion, while he crossed his arms, advanced towards me. More importantly, how did you know where she was? I glanced up at the unfamiliar room. Coming to the conclusion I'd somehow wandered the halls and ended in such a special room. Thinking back to previous conversation, I recall the toys convinced that only the young heiress remained loveless, even though she became a toy too. Is this Goldilocks? Aura. My voice. My eyes widened and I shivered at the young girl's voice from my dream called out to me again. Warmth swelled at my chest and a bright light shone where our fingers connected. I stood in a panic, the light swung to my chest. But whether it was from you or somewhere, I fully expected to hit the ground, so I had no doubt. Slowly, my body hurt less than it should have. To add to my confusion, it was hard to breathe. Something heavy pressed down on my chest. Oh my god! Did we seriously just have black oil? Surprise me as much as his actual voice. shocked. They're all freaking human now. Suddenly the door from the revealing more unfamiliar humans in a mansion supposedly populated by toys. I like the fact that I was a part of them. It's where my mind blew expression. There were two guys, both striking blonde hair. One hairstyle was short, while the other was tied into a small ponytail, complete with a green ribbon. There was a similar to their heads and features as if they were possibly related. Yeah, they're freaking twins, I swear to you. Or they're just brothers. Either way, they look like twins, don't they? To the left, and a beautiful lady with long dark hair and a fierce atmosphere about her stood next to him. My cheeks flushed again. I began to doubt my own appearance as somebody tried to fit in. Royal blocked his irritating look and placed much of it in surprise. Ask you the same thing. All of us saw the same bright light, and the next thing we knew, we were humans again. The party at the door all similar, and they went to the nod of their heads at one another. After a pause of awkward silence, Royal seemed to shoot me a fresh, venomous glare. I stiffened. I was amazed at the tiny bear vision of theirs. Explaining to do, girl. Tilting my head to the side, I could only manage a quiet grunt response. Even I didn't know what was going on. After a while, we all gathered in the dining room to discuss what happened. It took some time because soon after, to human form, everyone felt enough, their fridge had also been affected by the magic of the curse. I just opened the fridge and I can find whatever you need. Good as her yet. But someday, I'll show them the best chef in the whole world. There was the long delusional girl. You know what? Just screw you. Cheers. when should you open my eyes? After everyone had eaten, we started discussing everything from the beginning. As it turned out, the curse hadn't kept everyone from aging. They were now 7 years older. It was only 10. I was only 10 when the curse began. She paused, looking down at her hands, still trying to comprehend the years she'd been spent as a doll. The only word stuck in his chin into his beard. A playful grin spread across his face. Who would have thought that our little crybaby would become such a fine lady?
Thank you.
as ever. I had the mood shifted. You know, now that I think about it, they both have black hair. You see what I mean? This Maria and Kim, you know.
Out.
Apologies are only words. They are meaningless without actions. What do you expect me to do? You have no idea where that toy maker is. We're stuck in the mansion. I'm completely powerless. And live. I was taken aback by what I said. I'm standing speechless. You said that all you can do is apologize to her. That's how you feel. That you feel bad. That it's just an inspiration to me. I'm not considering that we're considering things. She'd been alive as a doll for several years, but the mistake of everyone talking was supposed to live your life for her. Which we were now it's kind of making her sad. Thank you. excuses, then I'm here to apologize. Of course you're here to apologize. What? He stirred up roast, uncertain I could not possibly have heard him right. What are you doing? Such a troublemaker. I know, you don't have to rub it in. We shared a quiet laugh. And I lifted his hand and her eyes met. I hope you don't tell others about what you said to me. Don't worry, I won't. I had gotten assigned work with Mr. Old Grumpy Bear.
Alright.
His attitude had been my sense of him. In fact, he often seemed even colder. However, I said I had taken a lot of him. Yes? He acted nothing like the one I saw. Slender hands slipped over me and flicked me in the forehead. I recoiled and almost fell from my claws. Ow! Dear, can we touch him on the tree? I could. But he only stared impassively back at me. Why did you do that? Shrugging away, I returned to his own window. Mr. Spider. Wow! Puffing at my cheeks, I went over to clean them. Once more, even though I can't see the smell a little bit. Call me again. Run on. I can stuff the gold wheel in my chest. Well, had it. Hesitated in response, even back to my gear then. I ran at the window and seeing no steps left, I moved to the left. I didn't want to have another drawer. peeking at Royal, I saw another nonchalant shrug here. You'll have to talk to Miss Maria about it. So good luck with that. I nearly dropped my coffee and called Miss Alicia. I imagine the annoyed look she would surely give me away. After only a few days, I had one idea about her identity and her clerical management. Also, tired of feeling a little nervous, I just finished up the rhythm first level. I then grabbed a nearby ladder and climbed up so I could reach the ladder. As I climbed up a pair of eyes on me again. Is this where we get him to hold us? I looked to the side and flinched when I saw when I crossed past the Royal's gaze. There was a flicker of noise with his eyes. Careful, you don't want to show off your hair. I flashed a huge shot off my face. My grip trembled against the ladder. You'd want to. Oh, you jerk, you would. Just a minute. Really, my teeth didn't stop my blood from flowing. This was not the kind of situation. Why, you idiot? Oh my gosh, dude, this is happening. Wow. Still riled up and proceeded to take another step when my foot slipped off the ladder. I squeezed in terror that now, even if I wasn't so high, the impact would still hurt. I shut my eyes, missing the impact, but instead of striking the floor, I felt my back fall against something soft. Yeah, it's his chest, isn't it? My heart so firm, I opened my eyes to meet the concern I spread across Will's face. Oh. Wait, what? My blood had become so hot that it was painful. I don't really expect that man was attractive. But being this close was too much for my heart to handle. Same! I tried to lean away, but there was nowhere to go. Well, on the other hand, didn't seem to notice. As well, I knew it was inside. But we were such a close. You know what, Prince Charming and Armor? Thank you. I only put blink in response. What? Let's see. So I'm gonna have to stop everything there. But I'll see you guys soon. Okay? Let's make this a quick save. Then let's do this.